Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over the NETWORKDAYS function in Microsoft Excel. So to give you an idea of what we hope to accomplish in this video, the NETWORKDAYS function allows you to enter a start date and an end date and calculate the number of workdays within that period.
Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that.
So to use the NETWORKDAYS function, I'm going to click here in C2, and I'm going to type equals NETWORKDAYS with a left parenthesis. And the first argument I will be prompted for is, what is my start date? So what is the first date in which you want to include in your count of how many workdays there are going to be? So in this case, let's click on A2 because that will be 1/1/24. And then I'm going to type a comma. And then my next argument is, what is the end date that I'm going to include in the number of workdays during this period? So in this case, that's in cell B2. So I'm just going to click B2 and type a comma. Now this next argument is optional. And what it does is it allows you to enter a list of holidays that should not be included in your count of workdays. So if you look over here, starting in F2, I have listed out the holidays that should be excluded this year. So I'm going to click on F2 and drag all the way to the bottom of my holidays into F12. And then I'm going to hit enter.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
And I can see that NETWORKDAYS has automatically calculated that there are 63 workdays between 1/1/24 and 4/1/24, excluding the holidays in this list over here. Now, if I click back in C2, let's take out this holidays optional argument. I'm just going to highlight from the last comma all the way to the end of my holiday range and hit backspace and hit enter. And now you can see that the number over here has gone to 66. A moment ago, it was 63. And you can tell that that's correct because I have these three holidays falling within this date range. We have some other options for calculating NETWORKDAYS in the event that perhaps you're wanting to calculate from another country where you have different weekends besides Saturday and Sunday, as well as a few other options that you can use for calculating workdays out on our blog. I will include a link to that blog entry in the description below on YouTube, so feel free to visit there if you would like to go more in depth on this topic. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them for us. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.